Very good morning once again. So now we are going to start with the topic pivot table. Pivot table is used for consolidating, summarizing and presenting data. What does it mean? Consolidate means when we want to club the data from different fields in the table. Summarizing means depending upon the need we want to make the summary of the data, and presenting means it's up to us how we want to present the data in different ways. What are the steps to do it? The steps are very simple. We need to open a worksheet and enter the data. After that, we need to select the cell and then we need to choose insert tab and followed by the pivot table option. Then certain options will appear in front of us and we have to perform the things depending upon the need. So let's go to Microsoft Excel. As you can see, the data I have in front of me, and any of the cell I can click and then insert and then choose pivot table. So when this create pivot table dialog box appears, it is basically asking for the range that you can see it's already selected, and then it's asking whether we want to use new worksheet or existing. If we use existing worksheet, then we'll have to specify the location. So initially I'm taking an example of existing worksheet, and suppose this area I have selected and then click on OK. As I click on OK, you can see that something has come in front of us and the message is to build a report, choose fields from the pivot table. So suppose the table which I want to create now, I am choosing roll number. You can see that sum of roll number has come, name. But now as the name has come and every name has a different roll number, so they both have appeared differently. Then house. Now the house has come according to the name under it. And if I deselect, it has gone. Activity 1, activity 2, activity 3 and the total. So this is the table which we are creating according to our own need. Fine. We are consolidating it, we are summarizing and we are presenting itself. Let's take another example now. Select or any cell and then go to insert and then again pivot table and this time new worksheet. So on the new worksheet again, the worksheet area is all empty with the message just to choose the things. So suppose I choose house, then name. So the names are coming under the house separately, and suppose the total. So total is coming. So this is what we want to present. We are deciding it. If I want to present the greenhouse students' name and their totals, so this much is sufficient. And if I want to display their activity marks separately, then accordingly I can select the cells. The way we have chosen pivot table, in the same manner we can go for pivot chart as well. We need to go to any of the cell, then insert, then under pivot table we have pivot chart. And again we can look for new or existing worksheet. And when the data will appear in front of us, suppose I take house, then activity 1, activity 2, activity 3 and the total. So accordingly the chart has come. And when the chart will come, then all the pivot chart table, all the pivot chart tools option will also appear. We can choose any of the tools and we can design or we can decide the way we want to appear the data. So dear friends, this way we can work on pivot table, pivot chart. The topics are easy, but it's all depend upon the practice. So you need to practice pivot table, and definitely practice makes a man perfect. Thank you so much.